So now we'll go to move on to fifth sum. So this is one more type of method to construct the histogram. Draw a histogram to represent the following data. But here, what you observe here, they are not given class interval. They are given class mark and the frequency they are given. So we have to find out what is class interval first. So in order to find out class interval, first we have to find out what is the class size. Already I told. So class size is equal to, you can represent it as H. So difference between two successive class marks is nothing but a class size. So that is 160 minus 150, that is equal to 10. Divided by 2 is equal to 5. That means we have to add 5 for 150 and we have to subtract 5 for 150. Then what we will get? Let us see. So class interval, now I will write here class interval. So first class interval I will take. So 150 minus 5, that is 145. 2. 150 plus 5. So that is nothing but 155. So now first class interval we got. So next class interval. Next class interval. 155 to 165. Next class interval. 165 to 175. Next class interval. 175 to 185. Next 185 to 195. Last 195 to 205. So in this way we have to find out first class interval. So once again I will explain how to find out class interval if class mark is given. So first step is we have to find out class size, that is H. So what is H formula? Difference between two successive class marks, that is 160 minus 150, that is equal to 10. Divide it by 2, then you will get a 5. So what we have to do with this 5? We have to subtract 5 from 150 and we have to add 5 for 150. So then we will get a lower limit and also upper limit. So 150, sorry, one step I removed here. 155 to 165. 145 to 155, first class interval, 155 to 165, 165 to 175, 175 to 185, 185 to 195, and last is 195 to 205. So now this is the class interval, this is the frequency. Now we have to draw the histogram. So we will draw the histogram now. So this is y-axis, this is x-axis. So along x-axis, what you have to do? You have to represent class interval. Along y-axis, what you have to represent? You have to represent the frequency. Now, I will represent, this is 10 differences there. So, but it is not starting from origin. So therefore, 2 centimeter we have to mark it as kink. First 2 centimeter we have to mark it as kink. We have to mark it as kink. So start from 145 to 155, 155 to 165, 165 to 175, 185, 195, 205. Now observe here frequency, minimum value is 8, maximum value is 36. Therefore, I will take 10, 20 also. 2 cm. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Enough. So, write the scale here. Scale 2 centimeter on x-axis is equal to 1 class interval, 2 centimeter on y-axis is equal to 10 frequencies. Now represent. So first one is 15. So 15, 10, 15. 15 will be here. Between 10 and 20. Next, 28. 28 will be 20. This is 25, 28 around here. 28. Next, 12. 12, 10, 12, 15. 12 will be here. 12. Next, 36. 35, 36. 36. Next, 8. 8, 5 here, 6, 7, 8. 8 here. Around here. 8. Next is 18. 15, 16, 17, 18. 18 will be here. 18. So this is how we can represent the data frequency distribution using histogram. So now we learned how to draw histogram in three ways. One is if they give the class interval in exclusive form, how to represent the, how to construct the histogram. Second, we came to know if the class interval is given in terms of inclusive form, how to convert into exclusive form and construct the histogram. Third, what we saw now, if class mark is given, how to find out the class interval, then to represent that frequency distribution on histogram. So these are the methods, different methods they may ask in the examination to represent the data using histogram.